You know what the best part is about buying a new car in November, getting all the parts you wanted for Christmas, and then finishing your build by January is? I don't know, because it's springtime and coronavirus, and we haven't gotten a chance to really drive it yet. All right, real quick, I want to apologize. I just uploaded the footage and I realized that we were out of focus for most of it, but it's hard enough to get my wife to cooperate to be in a video to begin with.
I hate this so much.
So we're just gonna go with what we have. We'll watch it on a small screen. Don't make it full screen and you won't even notice.
This video sums up where we're at after 2 months of ownership and where we're still at after 6 months of ownership.
So my big Christmas present to her this year was the STI replica wing, which, I mean, it's a replica wing, but it serves the same purpose. It's stable at high speeds, and I have no problem with it. It was $150, and it came pre-painted. We also had the carbon fiber vortex generator, which, I mean, that really helped kind of complete the back end of the car. We added the Rally Armor mud flaps, and that makes a huge difference in keeping dirt off the side of the car. And then the MPX front lip, which that front lip was only like $100 on eBay, brand new, with free shipping. But my point is, I don't know why we don't see more modified Subarus on the road, because the parts are so cheap. Like, for less than $2,000, we got all the parts that we wanted to modify that car the way we wanted to. I mean, just to buy a lip for a Volvo would have been like $500 or $600, and the one for the Subaru was $100. Now, I feel like there was one really big cosmetic change that occurred over Christmas, where visions of sugar plum, gloss plum metallic danced in our heads.
Oh, you mean the wrap?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes. The beautiful, beautiful purple wrap. I've always loved the color purple, and I especially wanted a purple car, but since you can't just buy a purple car, we decided to do the next best thing, which is to do a vinyl wrap. And I love the way that the Subaru rally cars have the swoop with the stars on it. So I wanted to do a replica of that, just instead of blue and yellow, we did black and purple.
We also installed a Morimoto HID kit. Now, I have experience with Morimoto kits. I did one in the past on our Project V50, and I have a full video showing in detail how we installed this kit on the Subaru. A link to that will be up here.
Oh, you're smooth.
Uh-huh.
As well as the Morimoto kit, we also installed an LED light bar because the roads are dark up here and I am blind. So we needed more light during the nighttime roads.
Yeah, but we had the rally lights set up on the V50, so we're used to having very bright lights. So to install the lights, it's pretty straightforward. I have another video showing how you install aftermarket lights on cars. But really, you have a relay, and it has four leads coming off of it. One of them is your ground, one of them goes to your light bar, one of them goes to your battery. Now, make sure you have a fuse installed on the line that's going to your battery, because it's your battery. And then the last one, I connected directly to the high beam on the headlights, so that way when you turn the high beams on, the LED bar comes on as well. In the past, we've used switches, and we've had some switches that would also control on or off with the high beams, but this I just wanted wired directly up to the high beams.
As well as a light bar, we went ahead and installed this kind of F1 style fourth brake light that's right underneath at the bottom that flashes when we hit the brakes.
I really like that. I don't know why everybody doesn't install one of those. It was like $30.
Yeah.
Again, super cheap for parts. I mean, maybe I'm just new to owning a Japanese car, but I mean, I really like it. And plus, the car already has that little cutout in the bumper for the light, and that's what it's designed for. So you might as well fill the fake plug with something real, and it's always beneficial to get people's attention when you're stopping. Another update to the interior was sort of permanently mounting a Garmin GPS. I took a Dremel tool and I carefully cut a hole in the A-pillar so that we could put the mount in from the back and then hardwire it in. So basically, the wiring is all hidden behind the dash and it's plugged into one of the 12-volt sockets. So it comes on with the car and turns off with the car, and it's a newer GPS, so we were able to actually get a picture of the car on the GPS at startup, so that's kind of cool.
And my very favorite interior upgrade was for Christmas, I got a Zelda Master Sword umbrella, and so Michael.
You were like a kid on Christmas getting that umbrella. she was just waving
so
it around.
Excited about it.
It was like the greatest thing she ever got.
So Michael went ahead and installed some mounts for that in the trunk, where I can just Velcro it up and store it there, and have access to it anytime I want.
And that's pretty much, I think, everything we've done now to date on this car. And honestly, we don't have plans to do much more to it because it's stage 2 plus right now, which is more than enough for a daily. It's fun and it's reliable. That's the most important thing. We bought this as a family car. Mm-hmm. And so if we're going to be driving around town. Oh, that's the other thing. The exhaust. So when we bought the car, it came with the NVIDIA racing exhaust, which was just a giant soup can coming out of the back bumper and pointing off to the side. Now, I get the appeal of like the whole slanted angle JDM exhaust, and it looks great on a Supra, but the WRX has the cutouts for quad tips.
Yeah.
And we wanted to retain that sort of that OEM appearance, plus the fact that it is a family car.
Yeah.
We're driving people around in this thing. It needs to be quieter. So we got the pseudo exhaust. It was pretty cheap and probably not the best exhaust on the market. But, I mean, it flows better than stock. It still retains a 3-inch piping. We didn't have to get an upgraded tune file. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot quieter, but it still turns heads for people who know cars. Like, you're gonna be like, oh, what was that? That sounds good. But it's not just screaming for unwanted attention.
Right. And I mean, it's not a track car. My WRX, it's not a track car. It has more than enough power for me and my driving limits right now. And honestly, it's like Michael said, this is our family car, but I didn't want to get stuck with the minivan. So I chose something with a little pep in it and
WRX.
That's why I wanted the WRX.
I will say no build is ever truly finished, and so I am still looking for an upgraded top mount intercooler, just because we live in the southeast and it gets really hot, and the car is tuned, so it definitely needs that intercooler. But that's
more
pretty much
means
everything.
More power, baby.
More power, baby. But I mean, to that point, this isn't the end of Subaru content that you're going to see on this channel. We still have plenty of videos we're going to post. We'll do how-to videos as we continue doing other things. Now, you can see a list of other videos I've done specifically about this car right here, I think. And then you can see some of our how-to videos over there. And that's pretty much it. I mean, don't forget to subscribe and continue following along with this Subaru adventure.
I don't know what to say here.
This part where we just stare awkwardly at the camera until time runs out.